Sturgeon built Fort Necessity to stay there. He didn't want to retreat. He was supposed to go up there.
They were out pretty easy. Sometimes we cheat.
Make ready!
One, two, three.
Present!
One, two, three.
Fire! Prime and low! Make ready. Ready! Present!
Present!
Fire!
Excellent, excellent. From the diameter of the barrel, checking for ease of loading. When I discharge the musket,
you're welcome.
The heddles hold each thread. Each thread has its own heddle. The harnesses are on like pulleys, or they're balanced. So if you, one goes down, the other goes up.
Because those people lived over there, they're gathering up these people to go over there sometime to look.
Again, and that was in October, and they They told George, you'll stay there until Dagworthy gets there. And then once Dagworthy got there, then they told George to build a road between Fort Cumberland and Fort Bedford.
Old road with some houses on it, maybe 100, 200 yards away. It varies from the house, but you can see that road.
What are the time periods of the moon?
Because it's so cooling, it may go more here, or it may go less.
I heard it on an album. It kind of sounds like ding, ding.
Going to be carrying it. You're out in the woods, you're looking for things to shoot at, so you're ready to shoot.
You can have it loaded, right.
This is all these things I carry in my bag. All right, what is this?
A scope. Kind of like a scope.
No.
Binoculars, pretty much.
Binoculars. This is not a binoculars. And look, this is actually a sunshade. You know, if you're looking at the sun, you can pull this out and the sun's not beating on your the end of the lens. Now, you can move this, open it up all the way except for this one, and you can put this up to your eye and see if you can focus in on something over there. Here, bring it over here and put it on the pole so it's holding steady. And then you can move that in and out to try to focus. Can you get something focused? Can you see? Okay. Now see, this is, say if you're headed out here somewhere. Now remember now, we don't have all these fields. Nobody's living out. All this stuff is woods. All this stuff is woods. And you need to get, yeah, that's all you had. You didn't have any maps because nobody been here yet. The Indians weren't selling maps. They didn't want us out here. Oh, you're
it crosses here, but here is where I've joined. This is the join where the two ends meet. And it overlaps and it's stitched together. So the pulleys, one pulley turns the flyer.
Okay. She's going to name your fleece.
Oh, yeah. Oh, thank you. I should get up and go see that.
Is it Leroy? No, it wouldn't be Leroy.
I think it was Agatha.
Agatha.
Oh, I love that.
My bread, and then everybody.
Several days later, Captain Mackey marched.
That's pretty good, though.
Blueberry nuts.
Ball would have to fit in tight, and you'd literally have to pound the ball all the way down the barrel because it needs to be tight against the grooves so that when it's coming out it's spinning. Mm-hmm. Now I'll show you. Let's go back. These are shooting 80 to 100 grain, and again, remember, the musket ball would be inside.
You see the weapons? Well, actually, a good number of the soldiers were simple farmers. Maybe they came from a small town and they had to learn how to be a soldier. On the left shoulder of the soldiers. And if the officers wanted us to be ready to fight, the commands would come like this. Attention. Join your right hand to your firelocks. Poise your firelocks. Open your pan.
I'll be right back to talk.
Handle your cartridge. Tear your cartridge. Prime with cartridge. Shut your pans. Cast about to charge. Charge with cartridge. Withdraw your rammer. Ram down your cartridge. Withdraw your rammer. Return your rammer. Shoulder your firelocks. What if you were in battle? What if someone was shooting at you? Would you want to have to wait for all of those commands? No, you'd want to be able to load and fire as quickly as possible. Fortunately, there's a simple way that the officers would get us to fight using 7 words in 4 commands. Those words are prime and load, make ready, present, and fire. Okay? Now, 1, 2, 3.
Prime and load!
Now, a good soldier should be able to prime and load 3 times in a minute. And you're not going to give these soldiers the next command until you see them completing the first command. And you're going to know that to be the case when you see them put their muskets on their left shoulder. And then we'll go from there. Remember, the next command is make ready. I'll give you the numbers first. 1, 2, 3.
Make ready!
1, 2, 3.
Present!
1, 2, 3.
Fire!
Okay, now the gentlemen have fired, but the enemy is still advancing. They probably should fire again, but they can't do so without the right commands. I'm not going to give you the ones now. You're going to have to issue those
prime
commands.
Prime
and load! Prime and load!
Firelocks, poise your firelocks, rest on your arms.
The uniform just consists of a linen undershirt, a red wool waistcoat with a linen back, and then the blue regimental short jacket with red facings on it, on the cuffs and the turn backs, a neck closure of some sort, whether it just be like a plain neckerchief or a white neck stock. Maryland soldier has. Then of course breeches. I do not have military style gaiters on like this gentleman does here, but I have like Indian dress on, Indian leggings, just made from wool. They're just sewn up into a tube and then tied up to a belt on here. And then
carry my gaiters that I'm wearing, they gave me. Of course, I have a military musket, bayonet. I have a old fuse belly box for my cartridges. I have my own that I brought from home, shooting bag and pouch. Plus, I have my own haversack that I brought from home. And I'm carrying my tomahawk with me, or my axe with me, and I'm carrying my knife, but they also gave me a bayonet. So I would take one of these out and shoot